criticizing a play entitled Miss Saigon.
Miss Saigon was created and directed by the creators of Les Miserables, Alain Bablel, and Claude Michael Zuckerberg, with lyrics by Richard Malte Jr. and additional lyrics by Michael Muller for the new Broadway production. Cameron McIntosh, the producer of Cats, Les Miserables, The Phantom of the Opera, and many other musicals, brought it to the stage. Miss Saigon has won over 30 major theater awards since its premiere in 1989, has been performed in 25 countries, and has been translated into 12 different languages. This play is set during the Vietnam War and begins in 1975 when the world's conflicting cultures and ideologies seem to collide violently in one city, Saigon. It's the epic and tragic story of a young couple in love caught in the middle of war-torn world. Miss Saigon reveals Chris, an American male Guy, who falls in love with Kim, a young Vietnamese orphan, who works as a bartender and a prostitute. When the city is destroyed, the lovers are separated, and Chris eventually returns to the United States. Chris returns to Bangkok with his American wife, Alan, years later. When Kim and Chris were in Vietnam, they had a son, Tam, who is Boy Doi, an English translation of Dust of Life. Boy Doi were America-Asian children, one American and one Asian parent, who are fluently shunned and abandoned following the Vietnam War. Kim raised their son on her own, and when they are united years later, Kim and Chris must decide what the future holds for all of them. It was premiered in London's West End in 1989 at the Theatre Royal, Drury Lane, and closed after 4,264 performances in 1999, making it the longest-running musical at the time. The musical premiered on Broadway in 1991 at the Broadway Theater and closed in 2001 after 4,092 performances. It is a sung-through musical, is an epic adaptation of Giacomo Puccini, well-known opera Madama Butterfly, 1904. The opera was inspired by John Luther Long's novelette Madame Butterfly, an Asian American romance published in American Century Magazine in 1988. This is the scene in the play that I enjoy the most. It begins with a musical background and precise lighting that focuses on the actress and actors in the play. The set scene was breathtaking and it was perfectly suited to the story. The costumes worn by the actors and actresses were perfectly suited to their roles. The words were clearly delivered with just the right amount of feeling and diction to emphasize what was said. People who act as soldiers also deliver the words clearly and act in accordance with what is right. How the soldier just punched Kim in the stomach makes me feel pity for her, because it was a real punch with the use of the gun's downside, which for me was the painful one. Even though he has a few lines to say, the man on the side plays his part. The general soldier also delivered the words clearly, even if his reaction was a little too exaggerated for me, but it really suited to him the way he speaks and acts at the same time. Just the right amount of emotions to give into the lines that he gave. Their lines were made faster at this point, but they did so with diction and a clear voice. I was moved to tears by how the mother and child hug each other, especially when Leia Salonga said, "You will not touch him. Don't touch my boy. He's what I live for. He's my only joy." This line moves me to tears, and the music playing in the background adds impact. The scene in the play exemplifies what a mother will do to save her son, just like how the entire setup of the play changes in an instant when the play reaches its climax. The setup evolves over time from dim lighting to the focus of the main actor and actress, as well as how the stage design changes when the general soldier is shot and the setup suited to the scene depicted in the play. When the general soldier was shot, the stage background changed from dim to black, and at the end, when Leia Salunga, who played Kim, shot and left, the background changed into a figure of a man with the use of candles. The child, too, even though he doesn't have any words to say, said it all with his facial expression showed in the play. I really salute all of the people who work on this play because it was so beautiful, a nostalgic one to remember that there were many pitfalls in our lives to come, and mother's love is the most genuine one. I really like this play. No wonder it has been translated into 12 languages. It is well deserved to be translated because it will move you even if you haven't seen or experienced this kind of situation before. Overall, the play was good, particularly the lighting, costume, diction, and emotion of the actors and how they were able to deliver this kind of line in through a song with emotion is fantastic. I would recommend it to others, and it is worth keeping an eye out for.